What's up, everybody? Day 240, Make a Songbringer, and today I'm working on a dash attack, some kind of like speedy thing where you jump forward and you attack, but you are also you won't be able to dash over the top of things, so you can't like dash across a gap of something. So yesterday, what got done was these little skid marks, so you can when you go from one direction to another. You can actually do it pretty crazy like this. This is pretty funny. Dance, dance, dance. So I got some ideas to make that even better. But today I'm gonna go and start working on a new item, a new ability where the dash attack. So, but anyways, there's that, and there's also this where you turn around. So that's kind of neat. It gives the player some nice weight. You did. What, Lime, you're the first. Welcome, Lime. How's it going today? What you working on? First thing we're going to need for this new item is an item index, so. We'll start putting these at the end. So we'll call this one the dash for now. Oh yeah, maybe. I hadn't even thought about it, but it's probably a good idea to have some turning animations for him too. What's up, Kofez? Belazio. So I guess while I'm here, I might as well add some other ones too. Ciao. What up, Pita? Marza? Nice. Is this sarcastic? It's fun, or is it really fun? Assembly, man. Must be a badass. It's Marza Power's B-Day today? What? Happy birthday! Is it really? Is it like tomorrow? Or is it like was today and it's kind of getting over for you guys? What time is it now? It's probably midnight for you guys, right? Almost. So there's going to be a dash attack, a charged up attack. There's there's going to be a shield, and there's going to be, I'm thinking there's going to be a run fast. It'll be tomorrow. All right. Happy birthday. Is it Feliz Cumpleaños? I'm seeking to talk in Spanish at you. Yeah, right. Hey, what's up, TM? Siri, whirlwind, possibly. I think this charge attack might be somewhat whirlwindy like. What was the other one? The sprint, dash, charge, shield, sprint. So you've got like a defensive one, you got an attack one, there's two attack ones, sort of. For now, these will be all right. It's Marza Day. That's what we do on Marza Day. Okay, next thing to get hooked up for these new items, new abilities, is to make their words able to parse. Oh, dang. Kofez, we're playing a game. A project with the Coco City is something like 200 megs. No way, yeah. No, the actual, if you're gonna keep Cocos 2D X, this is different than Cocos 2D, but if you're gonna keep a Cocos 2D X project folder with all of Cocos 2D X in it, just Cocos 2D X itself is 500 megs, if not 700 megs now or more, maybe even a gig. So yeah, I don't recommend it actually doing it that way. I recommend pre-building Cocos 2D X, then you don't have to deal with that. But yeah, your project folder for your game is always going to be more than a gig, like maybe 2 gigs. But in the end, the final build is maybe only 100 megs or 200 megs or 500 megs or something like that. But yeah, a lot smaller. What's up, MC? Yeah. Okay, yeah. Cocos 2DX, right. Yeah. Yep, they compile down a lot smaller. You can? Really? How do you do that? How do you do a pre-order button on Steam? Yeah. Where's the items? Oh, I guess because they're in here. Right, let's get these created. So we got K item dash. Really? Can you send me a link to one of This is one where you can now have one of them max. It's equipable. This one is not craftable. It's not an actual item. It's not passive. It's a skill. I'm not sure if I'm even using that those though, but we'll put K skill on there. Can't purchase it. Gotta earn it. Okay. Yeah, totally, right? Yeah, you gotta have everything in some data. Some clear, simple data that can be put in a file if necessary, or like this, it's actually built into the code because I don't want this actually to change. But you know what? I probably will eventually put this in a file so this can be edited or modded. Yeah. Just gonna leave it with the item blink for now. I think it's good. Item dash, item charge, item shield, item sprint. Okay, cool. Got them hooked up. Oh, whoops. Sprint. All right, well, I mean, this isn't so hard, right? The next thing, I guess let's give the player one of them. So we'll do the dash. Why do I keep typing sprite instead of sprint? So weird. Funny, weird. All right. Well, let me know if you do, or if you find any kind of links on how to do it or whatever. Nice. Right on. Cool, man. Interesting. So, wow, did you ever go back and try the other ones or whatever, or you just decided to stick with it? Oh, you did? Right on. Yeah, it probably because I don't know, but that's the whole point of, it's a good question. I don't know why they don't do that, but there's Gen Lives, Kofez, there's that, And there's rapid game, which are the two things which do that. Pre-compile Coco City X for you. Farming Simulator pre-purchase, huh? Yeah, so this is MC, this is actually not a pre-purchase. See, this game is actually out already. It's a $30 game which you can buy right now. This pre-purchase thing here is for some new downloadable content that they're going to be adding soon. So you can pre-purchase the new DLC on what comes out on October 29th. So yeah, unfortunately this actually is not technically a pre-order of the game. Oh really? Oh, Lunar Melt, cool. Wow, see, I never knew that. So they do have a pre-compiled version of Coco City X. Awesome, Akuma. Right on, man. Okay, let's run the game and see what we got. We should have the item dash now, which will have the exact same icon as the blink, but we should be able to equip it. Yeah, we got, what are these? What are all of these? Got no text for them yet. But why is it giving me all four of them? Well, let's create some text and see what those were doing. Huh. Yeah, I don't know. This looks like, is this created by Valve? This looks like it might be a little bit of a special case. Yeah, this is Valve. So yeah, of course Valve's gonna allow their own pre-order type of thing. But yeah, so the way the Valve does pre-orders is they basically have created this thing called, early access. So yeah. What up, Mighty Nest? Oh, did I? Oh. Thank you. Did I? You're right, yeah. Cheers, man. Let's call this one this charge. Shield. 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 Sprint. There we go. Cool. That'll help a lot, I'm sure. Let's add some strings, though, anyways. So when we actually look at them, they'll have some text. Whoa. Yeah, I do. Hopefully, yeah. I'm thinking I want things to kind of be cool so you can explore really fast. So the dash is really an attack. It's a you'll see. I'm gonna create it right now, but you sort of dash forward and attack. And then the sprint ability, I think, is going to be the thing that speedrunners are going to love. So sprint will be something where you can run really fast. That's basically all there is to it. And I think when you're sprinting, it will probably transition screens faster too. So sprint ability is going to be like the ultimate speedrunner item. Yes. Yes. No, it's good to have this data hooked up. I can focus on just art tomorrow and for the next ability and stuff. So, yeah, it's gonna be all abilities for the next few days. So I'm just gonna give some totally just boilerplate type text for now. Later on, I'll go and make this even better. Charge. Cannot type today. And concentrate your energy for a powerful sword attack. The shield. I think I'm gonna call this one Chi Shield. Because a lot of these abilities you get these abilities from fighting with your mentor, and he teaches you a lot of chi things. So a lot of these things are gonna be based on your chi and your bioenergy or whatever you call it. Mightiness, no, I'm not. I would love to be able to just share updates with everyone onto the Steam app, but unfortunately, the reality is that it's a hell of a lot of work to go and test that it at least runs okay on Windows and Mac and everything. So it's just like I could do that, but then you guys might have broken builds all the time. And it might not be that great, and it would probably slow down development a lot. So at this point, I really need to focus on all these new stuff that needs to be added before the game's done. So yeah, I don't know. I guess you guys would probably deal with it okay. The people that are playing the alpha right now would be okay, I guess, with having a broken build, but I don't know. I also have other people checking it out. There's people playing it that are YouTubers. People are playing it that are, going to review the game eventually. There's, lots of those kind of people too. They kind of need to play a stable build. So, yeah, I know it is. Yeah, Chi Shield. Type sprite again. Run really fast. There. That's all I'm writing for now. Right? Yeah? Yes. Right, now we should have the ability and it should look right. I mean, there shouldn't be four different blinks or whatever. Right, cool. Where's the blink? Wait, why is it a gear? Oh, because it's a skill. Huh. I might have to rearrange the way this works because this is a skill, but I prefer for it to be up here. I should probably get some kind of default picture for that. Whoa! What is this? Oh, nice. On a second. All of a sudden, my computer's going really slow. I mean, fan's going. Why is that? Huh. So tell me the concept of that then. No, yeah, it's not dying. I think it was just like I think it was that website maybe. But if it does die again today, I'm sorry in advance. Okay, since we have this ability, oh wait, can we bind it? Let's see if it can be bound to a key. Then we start doing the art. So if I put that to like X, yeah, I can, nice. Cool, all right, it's bound. Let's save it. Great, we're ready to try this out. So the next thing we need to hook up is the ability to use the item. Nice, that's all you gotta do. Just threaten it with the sledgehammer. You're gonna get the sledgehammer if you don't comply. Use item, all right, yeah. I think it's gonna be similar in a sense to the fire orb or the item blink. Fire orb is probably the closest type of item we got to the dash for now. So let's do it. Use item cactus, use item teleport. Use item dash. Mm-hmm. Oh, interesting. Okay. I see the risk. I see the reward. Nice. Yeah, I don't know what that was. It's probably Safari. Safari has not been awesome in El Capitan yet. All right, here we go. Let's look it up. In the actual map of items to use. And the last thing, let's start doing the code for what it actually does when you use this item. So I definitely want the player to sprint forward or like move forward quickly. So we can do a vector. Just like this. Vector from compass direction. So, I think it may be about 40 is the distance it will go. We have no animation yet, but that's fine. I don't want the player to be invincible. Don't need a sound just yet. That's it. We just need to do that and then apply it early. So e dot move dot velocity. Yeah, nice. Huh. So wait, edges, what is edge again? Is that the new, is it like the replacement for Internet Explorer or something like that in Windows 10? Let's see if this works. This might actually do something. Oh, yeah, yeah. Wow, nice. Well, good job, Microsoft. look up. He's barely even going forward. He's not even running or anything. That's great. Okay, we definitely need more than 40. Let's try 400. Oh yeah, so the thing about this attack is that it can damage enemies, so there'll need to be some kind of hitbox or something that it puts. Whoops. That's more like what it. But still not quite enough. Let's do a little more. Right. What up, Wolski? All right. So, okay, what's next? We want him to run to, well, actually, I'm going to do a custom animation for this, so it's not going to be a run. But it'll look kind of like a run, I'm thinking. I wonder how I'll do the hitbox part. Why is this? Is it this cave here that I'm in? I wonder why the player is turning around. Like, if I face north. Oh, he's not ever facing north. Okay, that's some kind of bug. Look at that. He never stops and just faces north. Can't you just be happy facing north, man? What's up? I'll deal with that later, though. So, yeah, okay, so what's next? The animation? Probably. Oh no, I know, I got it. We need to do some cool trails. Oh, it does? Oh, yeah. I guess it kind of is. Oh, yeah, he's always watching. All right, yeah, I want to do a sweet animation now. So we'll do. What's it like? It's like. Kind of like these particles, because we're going to be leaving behind a particle. It's kind of a trail, really. So yeah, we'll leave a trail, parent duration, and we might as well pass in a color so you could do different colored trails. Anything could have a trail. I'm wondering if this, I shouldn't try and make this so general at first. Like, maybe I should make this a little more specific and just make this a chi trail or whatever for now. But yeah, I can always expand this method or change it later. So we'll start with that. We'll do like a kind of, I'm gonna copy this fire sword particles function because it creates a bunch of particles, which is gonna be similar to how this one works. So it's what I'm doing here is I'm doing an animation for this new item for the dash, and it'll work with creating a bunch of sprites as a trail. It'll look like tracers or something like that, you know? Got the parent. The height of zero. Nice, right on. Which tips did I give you? Sorry. I give out too many tips every day. Yeah, so the life of each particle is maybe one, and this is the delay per... Okay, that's the delay for each one of them. The number of particles is going to be the duration over the delay per... That works. So it loops over and then does a callback on the parent sprite. Or it creates a new sprite. Good. Okay, but I want to create a sprite with the parent's sprite frame. So e.render.sprite.getSpriteFrame. You pass in nothing for that. True for the how it's pixel. Position of this sprite. It's going to be a child of area layer. For now, we'll do the sprites z minus 1, so it appears just behind the player. Yeah. So same as the player's position plus height. Okay, this will still work. Additive, color, run a fade. This is a move by. I'm gonna comment out the move by for now. Oh yeah. Oh nice, nice. Awesome, nice. Okay, so how'd it turn out, man? Did you update your icon and stuff? What'd you do? Has it improved? Has it helped out your results and stuff? It's probably too early to tell. I guess no, you can bet 24 hours, right? I think this is good. But this should be something like trail. This kind of needs the entity's ID. So that this doesn't ever conflict with two of them doing it at once. All right, I think we're ready to try this. So when we use the item, we'll do this animation. Enims. Trail. Come on, trail. Trail. What's up, autocomplete? There, oh, that took a while. You taking a little vacation there? Duration, 1 second, perhaps. Let's do, okay, I'm thinking this is kind of a purple color. I'm gonna grab a cool color for this. Okay, purple blue. Yeah, purple. Right about there. Probably gonna desaturate this a lot so it gets to be a bright purple. Like this is like chi energy, like bio energy. Maybe around there. Yeah, right on. See your yes no ratio flipped? You were getting around three no's to every one yes. So now it's like four yes to every one no. Dude, that's huge. Wow, dude. God, congratulations, man. Congratulations. That's awesome. You're gonna go through green light a lot faster now.
What's up, baby?
Make it purple. I guess this is kind of a purple color, is it? This is purple. Yeah, what's in it? What was the name of Lime Studios game? Yeah, you gotta post this in the link, man. What happened? Whoa. Dude, that was awesome. Oh, but they're not flipped right, so I gotta do their flips. So this wasn't quite what I was imagining here, but keep on working on it. It's loading. An error occurred. Thanks for that reference number. I'm gonna write this down. Make sure I call your 800 number and read all those off to you slowly. Login check store, what the heck? Yeah, it'll get better. It's definitely very, very loose right now. Dude, it's not loading for me right now. Well, I'm gonna save your link so I can check out your new icon and stuff later. Okay, so flipping X is pretty important. Set flipped X, same as e.render.sprite.is flipped X. Yeah, it should be fine. I don't know what's up with my computer. Or my internet or whatever. All right, good night, man. See ya. Okay, let's see what that looks like with that tiny change. I was imagining they would be more closer together, I think. So it starts to look really cool when you're running. Why are they? Oh, because there's a random element with the height. Yeah, let's not do this random element. This is kind of weird. It's so weird, it's like stutters. Why is it so stuttery? Okay, let's look into that stutter. Why would that be? Oh, there's a DRAN. No wonder. And I want these to be very uniform, so let's take out that DRAM. Yeah, totally. Meant to be trippy for sure. It's a chi, it's like a chi power, like your bioenergy. It could be more purple though. It's meant to be more purple. I should probably change that color. Yeah, that's more uniform. But it's supposed to be when you're when you're doing that initial movement only. So let's cut down on, let's take, make it like maybe only that long. Now let's change the color to be a little more purple. What'll really help this is actually an animation. I always keep on moving on. That's a little more purple. But still maybe not quite purple enough. Okay, I'm gonna do even half that. And why is the del? Why isn't it allowing? Why isn't it doing an? Oh. Okay, I know what it is. For each one of this is such a quick animation that I need to do like three or four per frame. Rage Paint. There's a built-in timer for each button you use. So you can't reuse it until like 2/3 of a second. So yeah, that's kind of built into all items have a timer. You can't reuse it for a little bit. Good question, though. Yeah. So like inside this loop right here, we need another count of say up to maybe three or four more sprites. So when you're moving really fast at the very beginning of this effect, there needs to be like four, maybe even eight sprites that it creates. And that's especially where it needs it, needs that. It is, right? Yeah, that's exactly what I'm trying to solve right now, the initial jump part. Ekloff, what's up, man? How you doing? Oh, I guess we could do multiple of these and do an offset. Yeah, let's do it that way. Let's do an offset. Yeah. Boogie. Welcome, Boogie. Yeah, okay, we'll pass in an offset. It still doesn't. Damn. I know. I've had a few of those issues today too. A couple images aren't working for me either. Yeah. Nice. Right on. What'd you do there? Yeah, I do. There's an article I read about how to contact the press. Where? Oh, I hope I can find this. Oh, yeah, first article. This is it right here. Check this out. This is a great little article. Actually, this gave me a lot of confidence on how to contact the press and stuff. I know, yeah, first one. There you go. Check that out. All your questions will be answered. And I forgot, I'm gonna use this in a new article I'm writing on how to do a Kickstarter. Okay, so we can pass in the offset and add it to the position so that we can do multiple ones per. Nice, right on. Stinky Pete, was it there? It probably was. This guy. President Z, what? Huh? So for each one of these, we need to do let, like, we need like an integer amount of frames per. This should be based on, okay. I was gonna put all this inside this loop, but I think it's better to base it inside the loop because then, it can be based on the player's velocity. So if the player's moving really fast, it'll put 4 frames. If the player's moving not so fast, it only needs to put 1 frame. Oh, y'all know how to do this? Okay. Oh, dang, hard line. We'll start over. Oh, no, that sucks. So count is 1 and then maybe more. Dang. That was a really big fail fish for sure. Fail fish. Maybe we can get a fail fish run going. So based on the player's velocity, right? Nice, we got 4 of them. 5? It'll be distance, so that float length is the length of the E dot. Oh, we need the E. E dot move dot velocity. Dot length. Hey, not bad. Yeah. All right, see you, Lime. Later, man. Sorry, man. I don't, but maybe somebody here does. Okay, so the length of this vector, let's divide it by like 50 or whatever and get a count off that. So minimum of 1, maximum of 4, or maybe 8. Let's start with 4. Okay, so there. Now we have a count of how many frames we're going to do for this one. And then offset will go based on the current I or whatever. Well, maybe just search around, maybe Google it or something. All right, oh, I got a better way to do this, actually. It should, instead of it being based on your velocity, which is instantaneous and current, it should be based on the distance you've moved during that frame. That way it'll be a lot more accurate. So if you've moved 10 pixels, you should have four frames or whatever. Yeah, so E dot position dot last pause minus E dot position dot pause. Either way, this is should be a, you're just grabbing a length off this anyways, which is squares and stuff. PMC, what up, man? Welcome to the stream. I'm working on a cool new ability where you dash forward and attack, but you can't dash over like gaps or water or whatever. Yeah, sorry, I don't know, man. Yeah, true. I mean, is your heart set on getting a laptop or can you get a desktop? Actually, this vector right here is pretty important to have. This will help us get the offset for each one. So auto the distance moved, we'll call this delta. And so the offset will be just delta times. We should actually do this. Auto, no. Offset dot set, no. Offset equals delta times. I guess we should make this effect too as well. Delta times something over count, right? Float J over float count. There, something like yeah. Okay, let's see if that worked. We should have a little bit of an offset per these frames. We should have like around 4 frames or so for 50 pixels. That's actually way too much now that I think about it. It should be more like 10 pixels. Right. I hope I don't have to actually go and debug this too much, but yeah, I will if this isn't working. Man, my computer's slow today. It's like it's compiling really slow. I don't know what's up. It's still not working really. Okay, I do need to kind of see a log. I'm gonna log this statement out. So this isn't something I can actually set a breakpoint for and check very well because it's an animation that occurs over time. You need to see all the frames running kind of at, you know, in one run. Yeah. He's the ghost. I'm the ghost of Rock. I'm going to pass in I as well so I can see the current index. Yeah, right? Yeah. I like breakpoints a lot because I don't have to go and type out these log statements and stuff. And they're typically more quick, but for animations and for things like that, where you've got to see all the results rather than just breaking on one result, log statements work a lot better. So we got a trail number. This actually should be inside this loop. I want to see the offset as well. So count offset. Okay, that should provide some insight. Because this isn't looking smooth enough for me yet. I want it to all be like a smooth trail. Uh-huh, yeah. Okay, that's all we needed was one of them. Yeah. Yeah, right. Yeah. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So it only did 2 frames for these initial ones. Yeah, so this count should be one of the, like, count should be here. And already I'm seeing that it should do more frames at the very beginning, so. In fact, maybe this is what's wrong. Maybe it's not doing one at the very, very beginning because it's scheduling one. And even scheduling something with a 0 on CocoStudio, yeah, that's what it's doing. So I need to make this all a lambda that I can call. Hello, Avendable. So I can't pass in I anymore, though. All right, so if I is 0, we're just going to call the function. Otherwise, we'll schedule it. So that should put in the first frame better. And then making this so there's more frames. I think we make it 5.0 and it'll do better. Nice. Yeah, right on. 2 terabytes. Sweet. Weird how they get ahead of him. Oh, that might be the offset. Let's start over. Yes, they are getting ahead of him. Oh, it'll be really nice to see that. You know what? The next thing I should probably do is start doing the animation because this is getting too detailed, too technical. Let's look at what that one outputted. So, right, it did 0 of 1 at the very beginning. Why did, because the very first frame, he hasn't moved at all. So the next one he does 0 of 4. 1 of 4, 2 of 4, 3 of 4, yeah. All these are doing 4, 3, 3, 3, 1. Delta, -7. It's weird how this delta stays so high right here. Yeah, Zeith, totally. More images closer to the origin rather than destination. Totally agreed. Yeah. Oh, it might be because of this delay per as well. But really, this thing is definitely going to need a good animation. So I'm going to, even if this doesn't even look right just yet, I'm gonna stop what I'm doing here in the code and go and actually draw an animation that'll really help it all look a lot better. Because right now, these tracer images or whatever, I totally agree with you. There needs to be a lot more trail and a lot less going on where you end up. But see, as if I'm running, it looks a lot cooler. And if I just stand here, it looks really boring. Why doesn't it do very many, though? It should be doing, let's do, like we can do up to 8. Yeah, yep, yeah, I've been programming for over 20 years, yep. Even if this doesn't work right, I should start doing the animation because I can dial in the animation or the details of this code later on, but I'd like to have kind of a complete effect going on. Oops. You see, it's still doing more frames at the end. It's like, I don't get it, but Oh, maybe because the first jump is so huge. I don't know. Yeah, I'm gonna do this later. Okay. Gotta tear myself away from it. Do an animation. So we can kind of like how he runs. So I'll do running. And he's also gonna have the sword out. I think he's gonna need to have the sword out for this attack to work. So that'll really cut down on how many animations I have to do. So running sword east, this will work. Yeah, definitely hardline. That's what we were just saying there. There's too many images at the end and not enough at the beginning, but I'm not gonna worry about it right now. I'm just gonna do the art part of it. Okay, so it's gonna be similar to this animation. All right, Craig out of the graphics tablet, let's start doing this. So what I want him to do is kind of like jump into the air with the sword. I'm debating on whether the sword should be going forward or backward. I mean, he's attacking. He's going to be doing damage to foes, so this is kind of like a combination of a speed skill and an attack skill. So I guess the sword should probably go forward. All right. So we can start with this frame, that's fine. And then this frame. Yeah, he's gonna be getting way more horizontal, like he's getting like more faster. And in fact, he's gonna stay in the air too. So he's gonna kind of pop up, stay in the air for this whole thing. Like when he runs, he hits the ground and takes another step, but that's not gonna happen in this animation. In fact, okay, before I do this, I wanna see how long the animation is. If I were to do just a running animation, like how long is that? How many seconds is that? Because I would need to know how many frames to do this animation for. Telling you, my computer is compiling really slow today. What is up? I didn't do it. You didn't do it, man. Why didn't you do it? Let's make it not overridable. Doc! What's up, Doc? How you doing, man? You still not doing it? What the? How you been, man? Why didn't I run this animation? I don't get it. Run. I guess it's a directional and M key I probably need. Maybe I need to do it forever. Yeah. Nice, right on. Birthday day. Cool. Awesome, man. Is it daylight savings there? Wednesday, is it next week? I think it's next week for you guys, right? You get your daylight savings ends or whatever. What could possibly be going on that's stopping us from running the animation? I should just do the art anyways. It's about, roughly a quarter second is probably about how long. Yeah, next week. Nice. So confused. Well, animation. It's going great, man. Yeah, totally great. It's busy, every day, 6 or 7 days a week making the game. Lots of cool new items and stuff. The alpha version came out, 2 weeks ago or whatever. And it's just gone great. This is a great new trailer. It was a lot of work. It was a lot of work to get it out, and I was kind of burnt out for a minute, but now I'm back in the flow of doing cool, creative things, rather than just fixing bugs all day, which is kind of got old for there for a second. Actually, this frame right here is almost the epitome of what this animation is about. So let's delete these frames. Okay, so I want to end up about there, but maybe a little bit forward. So we'll start with some in-between frames. Nice, right on. Yeah, I hear you about that. I hear you. Just looking for 5 minutes, that's it, right? To yourself. Yeah, no worries, man. No worries. The alpha version's better than the old alpha version. The beta version's gonna be even better than the alpha, so something to look forward to there. Okay, so I wanna reverse the way his sword is moving. In fact, maybe I'll do the last frame. Let's get to the epitome of how this animation is going to go. So it's going to be his sword is like horizontal, ish. Oh no, no you're not, man. No you're not. Nope, it is very cool to ECU you. We were talking about Amigas the other day, and I was thinking of you. I was like, that picture you sent me that one time. I think you had yourself with an Amiga, was it right? Is that right? All right, so the sword's going to be about like that. It's going to be a totally different torso though. Yes, yeah, I don't use Notepad, but yes, I use a text file. Yeah. I'm considering going with some better stuff, like perhaps either doing a GitHub repo. Or perhaps a track repository, I'm not sure. Yeah, I've heard of Trello is pretty good, but it's I from what I gather, it's not quite as organized. So I couldn't really prioritize tasks. I really want to be able to prioritize things. And like, for example, if I did it on GitHub, people could suggest ideas or whatever, and I could add things to milestones. Really? Oh, so is it? It is. I gotta take a little better look at this because maybe it is. Can you prioritize stuff? Or like add it to a milestone or something to just keep it organized, like these are the tasks I'm working on, or what? Oh, you so you can add different groups, and then each item can be part of a group. Oh, or colors. Okay. Or you can add labels too. Okay. Okay. Okay, I definitely have to take another a better look at this because I didn't know this was this awesome. So how do you know what this is? Why do I click on like, is there something that tells me like what this? It's just like, maybe this one. So it's just like a single line. Okay. All right. All right. So maybe Trello. Maybe Trello. Trello, GitHub, Track, something like that. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, making it public would be nice for sure. Yeah, exactly. I do want people to be able to contribute for sure. Either comments or just contributing new ideas, you know, or bugs. You know, bugs is a big thing too. You know, lots of bugs with the alpha version, so. Okay, so in general, I want him to be a little more. This is like, if this is the last frame, then I want him to be a little more slanty. But not the sword. Alright, so maybe something like this. And then frame between them. Something like that. And then another frame between this. Maybe one or two more frames. Okay. All right. Good to know, Rage Paint. Like, seriously, that might be a good way to do it. I'm taking my sweet time, though, getting it done, that's for sure. Just gibberish. The bots aren't even trying to get you to buy anything anymore. They're just spouting off gibberish. What's with that? That's right, yeah. We do need an emote for annoying bots. What's with that? Come on, dude, somebody that writes bots, at least make the bots less gibberishy? Not even trying. Yep. Yeah. Right? Okay, I guess that's good. All right, we need a frame that goes between these. Or do we? Yeah, between these two. So from there to there, and then this also. Yeah. Okay, that's pretty good for the final pose, final frame. But where's this one that needs help? Yeah, between these two, there needs to be one more. Maybe about like that. Ooh, that's ugly. G-post links too. Yeah, it's got to have links, right? It's got to have like HTTP. Oh, yeah. That's a great idea. I have not. I haven't played those yet, but I think they're both on my wish list. Okay, let's see how this looks. Okay. Okay, good to know. Thanks for looking into that, man. Thank you. Let's see how this looks as an animation. Oh, that one's really dirty, but I'll fix it here in a sec. It's funny how he gets like this little extra boost at the end. It's like did it did it. In fact, I think his legs should go into the last frame. Or maybe he should still be on the ground for part of this, I'm not sure. Yeah, Clone Geek, totally. That's pretty much that's top of my list is using GitHub for that. Track is like pretty good too. That's the adrenaline kicking in. Sweet, man. Are these TF2 characters and stuff? Wow, man. This doesn't look that... This looks pretty fun. I mean, for such a, like, you know, simple graphics and stuff like that, it looks like it's actually already fun to play. Nice, man. I like the isometric view. I think that might be a little bit better there. So it looks really slow in this animation, but I think in the game it'll look better. The only thing I want to do is clean up this sword right here in this frame, and then I think it's ready to try out in the game. And hopefully I can figure out the code for that, because I don't know, it was kind of annoying me there for a second, because like it wasn't wasn't playing the even the simple run animation. That could be because, oh yeah, it could be because it was the run animation is kind of special. Good enough to try out. Get rid of this gray background and the other frames we don't need really. Well, I guess we can just leave it in here for a second. All right, let's do it. Oh, one more thing. That needs to be 0.1 seconds there. And then can render it. Cool, we're in the right place. Rock dash east, render. What up, Pedro? Yo, yo. Maybe we got this now, huh? Maybe. So I'm gonna hook up this new animation. Oh, nice. Right on. What's tomorrow's party? Okay, if this worked, then we should have a dash animation going on while he does this, but I don't know if it will. Nice, right on, party tomorrow, sweet. With some old bros, cool. It's like the best kind of party. It's working. It's doing the animation over and over. Huh. Okay, first of all, okay, that must have been it then. It was just like it had a problem with, yeah. So the first problem shouldn't be forever right there. Second thing, we need to do an idle after. Nice, cool. What games are you guys gonna play? Oh yeah, no, he can dance, dude. Check us out. Last night, I was adding this in, and I was like, oh my God, I can just hold down one key and do make him dance. So he kind of dances, but I do want to improve this. So maybe if you do this in the future, like it will actually make him do a cool animated dance. What's up, Rocket Bunny? So here's the sort of the dance, right? This is more of like the that Mad Hatter type dance from what was that? You know what I mean? But that's what he does right now. So okay, there. Okay, it definitely needs an animation on the way out too. Oh, okay. I think I understand what I finally see what's going on with that animation, I think. Anim's trail. Keep talking, nobody explodes. Cards Against Humanity, very nice. FIFA, Tekken, cool. Is that what it's called? The Harlem Shake? I'm working on this dash item. So it's actually an ability. You get this ability from training with your mentor. And it's you dash forward and attack, but you can't dash over like water or other obstacles. You just dash, and if there is an obstacle in your way, you get stopped by it. Thanks, Hardline. I think it's not doing enough space between. Oh no, it's supposed to be doing it right here. Delta times that. Can't be. It should have actually only done if the last position. Oh, this isn't run on the tick. The player doesn't update their position. Oh, I think I understand what's going on now. Yes, right on. Yeah. Rugged Bunny, how did I get good at pixel art? Man, that's cool that you even say that. Because when I started this, I didn't know how to do art, and really, I started making art literally only a couple years ago. I have much more experience with programming and making music, but I recommend everything in this little mini series of videos I wrote called From Programmer to Artist. This is like how to become an artist, basically. And yeah, practice does make perfection, of course. But sometimes there's some blocks that people have before they become an artist that ever stops them from practice, you know, stops you from practicing or even trying. And I had one of those blocks because I believed in my mind that I couldn't be an artist. And so a lot of this is about that. First of all, you know, overcoming those things. And then it does go into the basics of making art and shading and coloring and choosing colors and stuff like that. Okay, once again, this is gonna need some code love, but I'll probably finish the animation first. So Pedro, I didn't have time to finish that last night. It took actually all day just to do what I did, but I did do this. I made it so yesterday, when you're running and then you change directions, the player wouldn't hit the ground. The player's feet would not hit the ground. So you would be, if as you turn really quick, you were still in the air. And so I was like, oh my God, the first thing I need to fix is make the player so that your foot hits the ground when you turn really fast. So you can still turn really fast, right? While you're moving, you can turn instantly, but your foot hits the ground, so there's kind of an effect going on where it looks a lot more real, and there's a little bit of skid. See that like skid particles or whatever? So there's that. I do plan to fix it up even more. I got an idea where the player can do a little animation. So he's when he does do this turn, there's a slight animation, so it looks a little bit better. So like if I just say you're spamming the button like that, it looks kind of weird because there's only two frames it's going between. But yeah, there can be better animation going there. How did I come up with my title? I thought about it for months, and just finally Songbringer came, and I was like, oh my God, that's a really good name. How did I get good at coding? This is also just took years. I read books. I read a lot of books. But what really the thing that got me to really love coding so much is that I wanted to make games. I just wanted to make games, and that's what gave me the impetus and the to learn how to program. And then I just learned from books, and 20 years later, here I am still making games. Yeah, there you go. Always be coding. Okay, so yeah, this animation where you're doing this thing, it needs an out. So you get to this point. Oh, no wonder there's something weird going on there. I'm thinking I'm going to duplicate this frame. And then sort of a landing. Do a frame. Awesome, man. Good for you. Good for you. I recommend this when you're first starting out. Yeah. Check these videos out though, Hardline. I'm gonna give you some a link to some cool videos from Extra Credits. You've probably already seen Extra Credits and stuff. They got some great YouTube videos. But this is a great video series. So while Hardline, while you're studying computer science, make sure, like maybe watch one of these videos a day or one of these a night or something like that. But they have this, Extra Credits has this whole series on making games. And every one of these videos is like great advice. This is incredible stuff. So anybody that's a beginner in making games, I recommend this to everyone. But here's that link. It's a playlist of how many videos do they have for this? 69 videos, but really the most important stuff they list right at the beginning. Fail faster. Don't waste time. Games must be good to their players. And one of the most important ones, I think, right, is right here where they start to talk about minimum viable products, scoping small, because that happens to a lot of people when they're making games and start when they start. They're like, man, I'm gonna make the best game ever, and it's gonna be just like this, and they have all these big dreams, but you don't have the skills yet to actually do that. So you need to scope things as small as you possibly can. And in fact, it might not necessarily be your skills that stop you from doing something. It's just the time involved in doing a scope of highly scoped project. So check those videos out, man. Check them out like one a day or so, or five a day, whatever you do. Just soak it up a little bit each day. Awesome. There you go. Yeah. What's up, QB the Beast? So this is a little bit of, now we'll have like kind of an outro. Oh, this one. Let's go back. So if you're jumping in the air, like, yeah, his left foot's gonna come down. Okay, so I'm gonna mess with this frame here. This frame, I want his left foot to be a little more in the front. You have computer programming? Hey, what's up, Blood? What up, what up, what up? There, that's good. Maybe his this leg is a little less up. Awesome. Cool, man. Second year. Cool. Where are you studying at? You don't have to say if you don't want, but I went to, where did I go? Oregon Institute of Technology. I never graduated, but I did study a little bit. I was actually making video games before I ever went to college. So when I got to college, I'm like, man, all I want to do is make video games. So why am I here? I'm already doing it. But I recommend school because you get to it's the people you meet, you know what I mean? You're gonna meet people for life. You're gonna make some lifelong awesome friends through going to college and all that. Something like this. Oh, cool. Right on. Yes, please, please tell me. Okay, so right, we need one more frame or this frame here. Leg comes down a bit. Maybe one more. I think that could work. Thanks, man. Yep, that's on the list. Yeah. Yeah. Pedro knows I know. Yeah, thanks. See how that looks. Thanks for following. Okay, so if I didn't even do this animation, we can kind of see a little bit clearer what's going on. If I don't do the trail, we can see clearer what's going on with the actual animation. Because the dialing in, this first is going to help because making the animation look right will just make the trail look really right. And then once the trail actually works without, you know, how it should. Yeah, well, that's the whole point of making it online and public. So I'm putting it on GitHub or something. Oh, first of all, the sword needs to be out for that to look right. Second of all, it happens too slowly. It's like it needs less frames. Oh, yeah, we can go and change that. Roiku. Yeah, nope, it's never said 400. It's always been. This is the every single day I change that number. This is day 240 making this game. And that doesn't include weekends, so it's not exact, but. Yeah? What's up with those? What's up with the dungeons? Awesome. Yeah, cool. Good for you. I'm stoked. I'm glad for you, dude. I'm glad you know what you want to do and also what kind of game you want to do, you know? So I can make the animation faster, first of all. It's already 0.05, but let's do 0.025. Yeah. Oh, okay. So you have situations where you accidentally exited the dungeon. Nice. Nice, right on, man. Yeah, I've seen your name before. Yeah. Cool. So what are you working on a game right now or something? Grubuck. What's up, Grubuck? It's cool. You guys are lots of old visitors. I've seen some old names here. This is great. What's up, guys? Oh, I get you. So you want it to Oh, that's such a great idea, Vlad. So just make it so the when you walk onto the pod or whatever, it waits until you stop. I love that. That's actually a really, really great idea. So elevators wait for the player to come to rest before activating. Good call. Easy to do and much better for the player. Very cool. Yeah, good for you. Good attitude, hardline. Nice, right on. Cool, Roku. Yeah. I want him to be higher. I want him to be higher. Higher. Yeah, I definitely, yep. I do need to work on that too. Same thing with Jib. He goes behind the rocks. Yeah. And sometimes I know sometimes I've got this bug too from people is that the top hat will it will get stuck too. Sometimes it gets stuck on some rocks. It's really weird. Yeah, this is looking better. I'm thinking maybe you should go a little farther. Nice. Yeah. Let's make him go a little bit farther in his dash here. Let's do a whole 1,000. Let's see how far 1,000 is. Yeah. Good for you. Nice. Good for you. Awesome. Yeah. Oh, I remember now. I remember. Yeah, I remember we were talking about that. You know, I found a really cool article, or not an article, but a video about that. I just shared it with Hardline. Let me get you this link too, because this is really cool and talks about that. Extra Credits has some great videos on game design, but here's one of the best ones, this minimum viable product. You know, now that you're already in the flow of like thinking, scoping things smaller and doing like, you know, taking baby steps more, you're probably already on this path, but here's maybe a cool video that might actually help you all along that path even better. It's called minimum, you know, it says minimum viable product, scoping small, starting right. There was a place where the bushes blocked my way, and I wasn't sure if it was on purpose. That is on purpose for some of the dungeons, right? So if there was something on the other side that looked like maybe like it was valuable or whatever, or was a trail going to something that looked like it might be important? Yeah, that is on purpose. It makes it so you have to have the teleport to get across those. Awesome. Oh, there, huh? Oh, that doesn't look as much like it was on purpose. Yeah, this might be wrong. I'll save this to the desktop and yeah, that probably was not on per that was probably a bug. Where were you on the map? You're right there, probably. So you can go down. Okay, thanks for letting me know, man. Yeah, good call. Very intuitive of you to know that. Okay, so let's see how far he dashes now with 1,000, and then we'll start bringing back in that cool animation or the trailing thing. Yeah, that's more like it. 1,000's pretty good. There's no north-south animation yet, so he does a weird thing. A sound effect will really help this one too. Doesn't really, it's not really like, you know, working yet because the sound, there's no sound. But okay, let's back in this tr these trails and see if we can tweak them a little bit before I have to close the stream down for the day. So what the problem with these was is putting way too many frames at the end and not enough at the beginning. It's like the second frame should have quite a lot of frames. I mean, second time it's called. See that? It only puts one at the beginning and then all of them at the end. Oh, this would look so cool if I could just get this right. Okay, let's work on it. No, let's pull this up. So the first one, it does a single frame. I see what's going on. It's not doing, it's supposed to use the old position plus the offset. So as you get, all right, cool. Hopefully that was the most of the bug was right there, hopefully. Yeah, high pitch guitar, power bend. That could work. That's a little bit better, but it's still not enough frames. So this is the beginning. It starts about there where it is a 0 of 1. Yeah, it's looking better, but I want to see a trail from the whole distance while you're, you know, I'm not sure. I think this has to do with the timing. We got a delay per of 0.05, and what is the game running at? Good, man. Yes, this is why I'm saying you have a good attitude. That's very important. And it happens naturally. You're gonna naturally fail and then succeed, fail, succeed, 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 whatever you do. It's gonna be natural for you to keep on moving in your progress of learning that because you love it, you know? Because you're passionate about making games, because it brings you joy just to make the game, you know? Okay, we got 20 ticks per second right now. So that 0.05 should have worked. But what if I do set that lower? Or what's the life? Oh, life of each one could be lower too. No, it doesn't need to be out. Not yet. Yeah, exactly. And sometimes a failure is actually the fastest progression you can have. You know what I mean? Sometimes you need those failures to learn something critical for the next thing that you're going to do. You know, I would consider my last video game, Hero Bash, I would consider that one pretty much a failure in the sense that it didn't succeed on, you know, finding a playership or also... you know, we didn't market it well and a lot of things, but like basically, oh, it worked. Oh, wait, it didn't work that time. But yeah, basically that the failure of my last game set me up for the success of this game. This game is doing really well. You know, it's already got a following. It's got backing. It's got funding. You know, it's green lit. Everything's just going amazingly. And it took me failing really hard with my last game to learn all the things I needed to know to be able to successfully market a game, to successfully create your own indie game on your own without any external marketing help or anything. So I think that's about it for today's stream because I need to get some dinner. But I think what's going on with this code here is that it's not timed perfectly with the way the ticks run. So I think that might have something to do with why it's not running the complete. See, that time it worked too. That time it worked. But that time it didn't. It's actually looking really cool though, right? So it needs a little bit more to be functional too. Like if I dash through an enemy, I'll probably get hurt, and the point is for you to hurt the enemy. So this is hard to dash through these guys. Oh, there. See, I didn't hurt him. I hurt myself. So what I'm gonna do tonight to finish off this effect is make it so it becomes a melee attack. So you'll actually be able to hurt enemies while you're doing this. I'll add a sound effect so it's just sounds cool. Yeah, basically I'm just going to finish up this effect. Whoa, what's happening? Look at that. Jib's just scanning him over and over and over. Jib, what are you doing, Jib? Right, true. The last game never had Jib. What's up, Jib? Why are you doing this, Jib? What happens if I kill another enemy? Dude, I've never seen this before. Jib's totally stuck. Why are you so stuck, Jib? What's wrong? What's wrong with that guy? You can't scan him? What happens if I run off the screen? Oh, he comes back. All right. He's not stuck forever. Are you going to try and scan this again? No? Okay. He's happy now. All right, so yeah. He's making a point. His point is there's tons of bugs. Yeah. Debug this now or you won't find it again. Oh, but I don't want to right now, Jib. I don't want to right now, Jib. I want dinner. Oh, man. Yeah. Could be. All right, so yeah, that's it for today's stream. I'll be back tomorrow. And be working on a new item tomorrow. It might have been that. Yeah, it might have been just he actually was trying to get closer and closer and closer and just kept getting just on the other side of it or something. But I'll note this and get to it at some point. So cheers, you guys. Have a good night. Thanks for joining. And we'll see you next time.